an eccentric plank row or renegade row, we'll start in a plank position with our hands around the handles of the dumbbells or if you have kettlebells, that works too. Now with this, if you have two, either dumbbells or kettlebells, you can alternate sides, okay? If you only have one, then you can do all reps on one side, then all reps on the other, or you can do rep, pass it over to the other hand, and alternate. So you pick what's gonna work best for you. Let's come up to that plank position. Now if your feet are closer together, it's gonna be harder. So if you're newer to this, step your feet a bit wider, and as you get better at it, you can walk your feet closer together. Straighten your legs, squeeze your glutes, engage your core. From here, inhale, and as you exhale, row one weight up with your elbows sliding past your waistline, feel your shoulder blades squeezing back, back, back. And now this part is where it gets a little different than a regular plank or renegade row. We're gonna lower down slowly, slowly. Whew. Lower and switch. Lift it up, lower it down slowly. So I want you to take your time on this. Hold for a count here and then lower down slowly and focus on really keeping your core engaged as you lower down because your body will kind of want to rock side to side, but we really want to keep everything nice and stable through our torso as we slowly lower back down. Now, as you get better and better at this, you can go for longer and longer on the way down. So maybe you start out, you know, one count down, two counts down, then work your way to three counts and continue to work your way up. If we're working together, then I'll tell you how many counts I want you to take on the way down. I should have been here, right? How many counts I want you to take on the way down for this exercise.